Alrighty, so we have one of our most controversial videos coming out today. It's our second part to a new series, Cedar Point Conspiracy Theories. Just so everyone knows, we got a lot of questions after our first video. It seems like this is a really popular series. I wasn't expecting it to kind of take off the way it did. I mean, I was expecting this to be a popular series, but I wasn't expecting it to be as popular as it is. Lots of people are asking me, are we going to do other parks? Yes, the question is answered as yes. We will eventually be moving on to other parks. Cedar Point will only last so long, and then we'll move on to another popular park like Six Flags Magic Mountain maybe, or Valley Fair, or, you know, Kings Island is a great one. So we'll be moving on to other parks like that. Anyways, let's get this started. So one big topic discussed lately in the coaster community is they're split pretty evenly on this. You have a lot of people who think that Magnum could be removed. In fact, a lot of people are starting to think that Magnum could be replaced by something a lot larger. And I'm here to discuss both sides. So these videos are meant to be the devil's advocate, and then I will give my personal opinion at the end, whether it be a win or a fail. So again, the rumor being discussed today, the conspiracy theory is, will Magnum be demolished for another coaster? So a lot of people are saying it's going to be demolished to make room for a much larger coaster. A lot of people are saying almost like a Lift Hill Strata coaster. And there isn't much reason that they think this is going to happen other than that. So a lot of enthusiasts are saying that this, I shouldn't say a lot. There are some enthusiasts that are saying because it's uncomfortable, it's going to be replaced by something better. It's going to get new B&M trains on it. There's many rumors circulating around Magnum. It's sinking, and it's going to be replaced by another coaster in 2020. I'm going to go over the reasons why not more in detail, just because there really isn't a lot of reasons why, other than people find it boring now, people find it painful, people think it could be make room for a lot larger of a coaster to go along the beach. There isn't enough proof to present to you guys in this video that suggests this coaster is going to be removed. And I never want to present anything that is coming out of thin air like that. Now, let's get to the easier part of this video. The easier part of this video is why I think this ride will not be removed. So you just got my personal opinion right there. This ride is not going anywhere in my personal opinion. I think this is a giant fail of a conspiracy theory. I think that in the time of a roller coaster war with Six Flags Magic Mountain, even though it's not a full-out war, it's starting again, it's not the right time for Cedar Fair to be removing roller coasters from its roller coaster capital of the world, in quotations. So Magnum is still a top five for ridership as of 2016. So right there, that tells you it's not up for removal. Cedar Fair has been quoted on stockholders' calls saying rides that are unpopular and have low riderships and high maintenance costs will be the ones on the chopping block. Magnum isn't near there yet. Magnum is still a very popular attraction despite its roughness and age. So a lot of enthusiasts sometimes hate on older attractions because they get rough, or we tend to get a little more bored of them because sometimes enthusiasts are at the park a lot more often than other people, like general public. So we get bored of attractions sooner than the rest of the public. So sometimes we have to put that to the side and realize that this ride isn't worn out yet. And I think Magnum is actually one of the most underrated coasters at the park. Magnum and Blue Streak, in my opinion, are very underrated rides at Cedar Point. Magnum is one of my favorite coasters at Cedar Point. I know you guys are going to hate on me down below for stating that, but I love the coaster. It's amazing. So Magnum does take up very little in the park land itself. So in terms of space, it doesn't take up much space at all. And you have to look at the bigger picture here. There's other spots of land that Cedar Fair could build on that would still prevent them from removing coasters during a coaster war, in quotations. Magnum comes with a lot of history as the tallest, fastest, and steepest complete circuit coaster and the first hyper coaster in the world. It doesn't make sense for them to go after that kind of a coaster in the park and demolish it to replace it by something newer and bigger. There's other things they could do or remove before even touching this beauty of a coaster. As you can tell, I am biased in making this video. I'm trying very hard not to. Again, I will get back to some of the reasons why people think this could become a bigger attraction. But as you know, there really isn't that many. Cedar Point at the current moment can't afford to remove a coaster without adding one immediately. So if this was something bigger coming in 2020, let's say, you would already see an announcement for Last Ride. You would already see signs of this coaster being removed. Yes, Witch's Wheel was removed. Yes, Dinosaurs Alive closed. But there's still not enough evidence to suggest that Magnum is being removed anytime soon. Again, there would be a Last Riders auction or a Last Riders kind of event of some sort, or even signage saying, get your last rides in, especially for a ride like this. And that is not happening. So this ride is not going anywhere anytime soon. Cedar Point still has a lot of viable land to use for future coasters without removing coasters like Magnum. So as I just said, this coaster isn't going anywhere. There's much more property they could use. You have Shoot the Rapids, you have Cedar Creek Mine Ride is one of those coasters that I could see going well before Magnum. And then you have land other than that as well. You have the Dinosaurs Alive land that's being used for a small-scale attraction coming in 2019 that could be used down the road. I have a feeling this new attraction isn't taking up all the land, and it doesn't take up much airspace from what I understand so far. So there's still a lot more land to use for a future attraction. It still ranks really high on the Golden Ticket Awards as well. In fact, I think it was 13th back in 2014. I could be wrong, but I think it was 13th, and it's still pretty high on the Golden Ticket Awards. So as you know, it's still a popular attraction even amongst enthusiasts. So all in all, removing Magnum doesn't make any sense as a business standpoint right now. I get it. Enthusiasts want to see bigger, better attractions. Trust me, I'm one of those as well. But picking on a coaster like Magnum just seems a little much. Magnum is an amazing coaster. It has awesome airtime. It is super underrated in my opinion. And it is not on the chopping block anytime soon. So again, I think this is a giant fail of a conspiracy theory. And I think we need to let it go and move on to maybe things like, the Shoot the Rapids location. I get it. Cedar Point is definitely getting something in 2020, but it is not the removal of Magnum. Anyways, I want to hear from you guys down below. What other conspiracy theories do you think Cedar Point has? I would like to cover them in future videos. Again, the conspiracy theories for Cedar Point and future parks or other parks will be every Monday. So comment down below any conspiracy theories for Cedar Point that you would like to hear me cover, and I'll cover them in future videos. Hopefully you guys liked this video. Again, I also want to hear from you. Do you think this is a win or a fail of a conspiracy theory? Comment down below that as well. Give the video a like, subscribe if you haven't, and share this video for others to enjoy. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and have a great one. Bye.